This snowy landscape photo has a serious problem shared by many similar images. You can't see the detail in the snow. In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily fix this with a simple adjustment. Although I'm using Photoshop for this, you can do exactly the same thing in Affinity Photo. I'll start by adding a new levels adjustment layer to the image. Then I'll move this center control level over to the right. When I do this, you can see the detail returning to the snow. Unfortunately, it's also making the rest of the image look terrible and dark areas are turning black. The way to fix this is with a layer mask that targets the adjustment onto only the snow. To create this, I'll select the mask attached to the levels adjustment layer and invert it. This turns the mask black, which hides the effect of the adjustment across the entire image. I can now use the brush tool to paint white onto the mask in areas where there's snow. The only problem I'm going to have with this though is that it's impossible to paint only over the snow. But there is a technique we can use to make this easy. We can create a selection using the information in the image to select only the lightest areas. Then when we paint through this selection, it restricts the brush strokes to the snow. To create this selection, we'll use the channels window where you can see the individual color channels in the image. Because there's very little colour in this image, all three channels are roughly the same, but that isn't always the case. I'll pick the blue channel for this by clicking it. I can then load the channel as a selection using this icon at the bottom of the channels window. You can now see the marching ants appear on the image, showing there's an active selection. I then need to return to viewing the colour image rather than the blue channel by clicking the RGB option at the top. I can then switch back to the layers window, ready for painting the mask. Now before I start to paint, I'm going to hide the marching ants because they're making it difficult to see what's happening. The easy way to do this is by pressing Command and H on my keyboard. If you're using a Windows PC, that's Control and H. I can now paint onto the layer mask with the brush tool while using white. I'll also configure the brush tool to have a soft edge and an opacity of around 20% to help blend my brush strokes. Now when I paint with white on the layer mask, it's applying the levels adjustment to those areas. As I paint, you can see the details returning to the snow, but it's not affecting other areas. The reason we didn't see any detail in the snow is because of a problem I call tonal compression. If you look at the original histogram, most of the tones in the snow are compressed into a very small area at the far right. Unfortunately, our eyes have a hard time of distinguishing between these different tones, meaning we don't see any detail. This is a typical problem in many snow and fog scenes, especially if you've increased the camera's exposure. Now you might be thinking you can easily fix this in your RAW converters, and in fact some RAW converters do have a levels adjustment you might be able to use. But most of the time, trying to separate bright tones in RAW processing is extremely difficult. Now if you want to achieve more control over the mask, you can use a luminosity mask to paint through. Let's clear this mask and start again. This time rather than using one of the image colour channels, I'll use a luminosity masking tool. There are a few of these on the market, but the one I'm using here is Lumensia, and for no other reason than I like it. I'll include a link to it in the YouTube video description below. Using the buttons in the Lumensia interface, I can check what we call the lights masks to see which one I want to use. What I'm looking for is a mask that separates the snow and the darker areas in the image. The L2 mask looks about right for this example. I can then load that mask as a selection by clicking the cell button. I'll then hide the marching ants as I did before by pressing Command and H. And now I can paint over the snow in the foreground to apply the levels adjustment. If I hold down my Option key and then click the mask thumbnail in the layers window, you can see the mask I've painted. Notice that I'm painting more white into the foreground than in the distance. This helps to retain the softer misty feel there and creates a feeling of depth. If I make a mistake whilst I'm doing this and paint over an area that I don't want to, I can easily fix it. I just need to switch my brush to painting with black rather than white by pressing X on the keyboard. I can then paint over that area where I've made the mistake. Now one problem you might encounter when using this technique with some images is that it can exaggerate colour. If this happens, you can fix it easily by changing the blend mode of the layer to luminosity. When the mask's finished, I can adjust the level settings to refine the effect. And of course, I can change the opacity of the levels layer to also control the strength. Using a simple levels adjustment, I've been able to bring out texture in the snow that's otherwise hidden. If you'll want to know more about using the levels adjustment in Photoshop or Affinity, go watch this video next. It explains all the controls and how to use them to control image tones.